All right, welcome back, good people. On this video, I'm going to call this the continuation of how to make your content go viral. This is the first thing that comes to mind when you think about making your content go viral is a lot of hits, right? A lot of numbers. The numbers increase astronomically, where today you put the video on and tomorrow you have like a million hits. Boom, that's called viral, right? It went whoosh, like you set it on fire. What happened, right? How did that happen? And how do I duplicate it, right? What happened was a variety of things. And this list that I'm going down, a lot of those things were in play. This one right here is arouses emotion. In order for you to get anyone to take any kind of action, you generally need to push an emotional button, right? This is why people eagerly finish the books. They're sad when they're done with it, and they discuss the book with others. Generally, this happens when they connect emotionally with a character. While certain strong negative emotions like disgust can and do go viral, researchers have discovered that the biggest viral pieces tend to invoke positive emotions, which is good news, right? Because, you know, we want to do good, right? We want to feel good. We don't want to be always empathetic about someone who, you know, had a bad situation. Now, good emotions are things like surprise, amusement, delight, hope, excitement, joy, interest, right? Number six I want to talk about is enjoyability. Enjoyability, that's a word. I just created it. No, enjoyability. Think about that. When people enjoy your content, they want to share it with others so they can enjoy it too. People want to share their joy with others. In some cases, people share content with their friends so that they can discuss the content, such as, hey, have you seen this video? I'll tell you, I'm going to send you this video and you tell me what you think about it. We'll talk about it when we get together, right? Things like that. And sometimes people share content with others because they enjoy sharing and rising their own status. We call that ego. Before people share any content, they think about how sharing will affect their status in the community or among the circle of friends. That's right. Sharing can be the act of narcissism or even outright ego stroking. Number one, think about this. Identity. And number two, status. Identity and status building. One builds your identity, the other builds your status, right? Identity building, it's the idea that people share content that supports their worldview and builds their identity. Things about how social media works. So many people have thousands of friends from all around the world. Their connections are people with whom they never had one conversation. Think about that. Like, I've got some Facebook pages with 5,000 friends, right? I don't know those 5,000 people, but they're 5,000, 10,000 people, right, are friends. And the truth is, these folks don't have time to build individual relationships with everyone in their process either. They do not have that much time. It doesn't work like that. So what they do is share content that basically says, this supports my worldview. This is what I think, and this is who I am. Okay? Now, status building. The concept here is that people share content that will make them look good in the eyes of their friends, which in turn makes them feel better. That's right. This is purely an ego play. It's a way for someone to build social capital, which they may cash in and spend at another time. Three ways people use viral content to build their own status in a community. Number one, people like to be the first to share cool content. This person likes to be seen as the one who always finds and shares the cool stuff first. You know those people? Me too. Second, people build their status. The way people build their status is by sharing content that helps others. It makes them look good to their friends, and it makes them feel good also. 3, people share content that will make others feel good. We've already talked about this just a bit earlier, in that people who enjoy something will want to share it so that others can enjoy it also. Relatability. People share when they're able to relate to content. Different types of people relate to different types of content. And that's why you need to know your audience inside out before you even attempt to create viral content. Now, some things to consider learning about your audience are, because you're creating an audience, right? As you create content and people read it or watch it or listen to it, it becomes your audience. They become people who come back again and listen, come back again and watch, come back again and read, right? So you're creating that audience that don't exist as of yet. That audience, some of the things that to consider when you're creating that audience are their age, their gender, their familiarity with pop culture, their taste in music, movies, books, and sports, their education level, their interest, their fears, their hopes and dreams, things that make them laugh, things that frustrate them, things that outrage them, things that motivate them to take action, and anything else you can find that you could use as in your target market, right? And the final thing I want to talk about in this segment is connectability. On social media, people aren't having one-on-one conversations with all the contacts in their friends list. So they post something through provoking, they post something thought-provoking, something controversial, and something that otherwise will engage others. So maybe the other people will just like the content. Better yet, perhaps the others will discuss it with the person who shared it. That's a great way to connect or reconnect with friends and people you meet online, right? Now, I'm probably not telling you anything you don't know or hadn't experienced already, but sometimes it just feels different when you're hearing it, because we learn by hearing the word, right? Whatever the word is. Well, the word I just shared with you is the word you just learned because you heard it, right? Now, you could have also been watching this video, which is probably what you were doing. But although you're watching mannerisms, right? You're hearing the word, right? Get it? That's how it works. Listen, this is 2000. I'm not going to tell you the year, because when I use these videos later in life, you're going to say, hey, those videos were made 5 years ago. Hey, those videos were made last year. So when you're creating your content, be mindful of that. You don't want to be too open with certain things like dates and years and stuff like that, because you can always use that content, right? That's the way the game is played. You want to play the game the best way, right? You want to win at the game, right? Me too. My name is Larry James. My company is Speak with Larry, and I'll see you on the next video.